What's up, everybody? And you are listening to the best of the Media Mike Radio Show. I'm your host, the Media Mike Speaks, sponsored by New Justice Media, where we are the voice of the everyday citizen. The time is now 17 minutes past the hour here in the Lone Star State. So let's get to it before it's too late. All right, good people, can't say I didn't tell you so. But I had to jump back on here because one of my subscribers hit me up with this news. And you can't say I didn't tell you. Yeah, it is political, or at least it seems it is getting that way. So now, the deceased shooter, Mauricio Garcia, has been linked to the acronym or a group known as the Right Wing Death Squad. I guess the name speaks for itself. And I'm going to give my thoughts on this because this is really peculiar. Because it reads, the man who police believed killed at least 8 people at a mall in Allen, Texas on Saturday afternoon wore a tactical vest with a RWDS patch on it, sources told the Washington Post on Sunday. The acronym, which stands for Right Wing Death Squad, is a popular insignia among white supremacist, neo-Nazi, and paramilitary personnel. Paramilitarists, I guess those who, anti-government individuals, I would say. Interesting. No motive in the shooting has formally been established by police, but the presence of the patch, among other factors, has reportedly contributed to authorities approaching the mass shooting as a possible hate crime or domestic terrorism incident. Now, I find that kind of strange, the word hate crime here. The word hate crime. Let's continue. And this is really weird. The suspected gunman, identified as 33-year-old named Mauricio Garcia, has no prior criminal record. But according to FBI records obtained by Rolling Stone, his social media accounts contain hundreds of postings and images to include writings with racially or, ethnically motivated violent extremist rhetoric, including neo-Nazi materials and material exposing the supremacy of the white race. The outlet also reported that Garcia may have had ties to a local neo-Nazi group. Okay. Now, this RWDS patch has been seen in recent years on the clothing of some members of the far-right extremist groups at marches or protests, particularly in the days leading to the January 6th 2021 insurrection at the Capitol. There it is, according to the Southern Poverty Law Center. Told you, making it political. This is nothing, in my professional opinion, is a political battle between the Democrats and Republicans. Actually, they're trying to bring it back to Donald Trump. Because it goes on to read, on December 12th, 2020, several members of the Proud Boys, which the SPLC defines as a hate group, wore RWDS on their hats and patches as they gathered in Washington, D.C. Now, even though the Proud Boys was made up of mixed group of people, they're an interracial group, black, white, Hispanic, I don't know, maybe Asian, I don't know, but they were not totally one race. You see, this starts to get weird. I mean, this is really, really weird here. Well, let's continue. In 2021, the Daily Beast reported that an active duty U.S. Marine who was linked to a private chat group that called itself Right Wing Death Squad was under federal investigation for allegedly plotting to attack the Democratic National Committee with explosives, rocket launchers, and automatic rifles. You see here? Democratic National Committee. Yeah. This is really getting weird here. They're saying as far back as 2018, it was reported that Proud Boys were showing up to rallies wearing RWDS on the sleeves of t-shirts with a different far-right meme concerning Chilean dictator and mass murderer General Augusto I guess Pinochet. Okay. Here's the thing about this. I know the police searched the home. I don't know what they found. I know FBI went in the home, according to sources, what they're saying. But when it comes to the victims, God rest their souls, and we're praying for their families. Were they African American? Now, there are photos I did see online, and they were horrific, because I'm not going to show that. No. Okay. Now, I don't know if Mr. Garcia is of Latino descent or Mexican or Puerto Rican. I don't know. You know, just because he has the name Mauricio Garcia doesn't mean that he is. But, okay, let's say he is. You know, let's just say speculate, shall we? This is Texas. Has a high population of Latinos and Mexicans. Hispanic, yes. And from what I saw during some of those photos, I didn't see everyone. They haven't shown everyone. As far as the pigmentation goes, they were not African American. So let me get this straight. So we have a right wing death squad group linked to neo-Nazism, which is, you know, linked to white supremacy. The right race, you know, it's all right because it's all white, shooting people that look like them. You see, this is going sideways. I'm not understanding where this is going, because he said hate crime. Who are you hating on? Because let's say he's a Hispanic and he shot at Hispanics. Does that make any sense? Let's just say, I'm just speculating. Let's say he's Hispanic and he shot Caucasian individuals. I'm not understanding this. Does this make any sense? You see, the Buffalo shooter specifically targeted individuals by race, by witnesses, accounts. He said it. Yeah, I did. Yeah. Okay. Hate crime. But this, I'm not following here. Something is off. Help me understand this, good people. For your mental sake, do your homework. Don't buy into everything. I'm just saying. Because it doesn't make sense. How can you? It's a possible hate crime because of right wing death squad. Now, I'm not condoning, you know, this right wing death squad. I don't know what they're all about. But if they're trying to link it to white supremacist neo-Nazi. Okay, so what are they doing now? What are we just? You just shoot your own here? Is this what's going on? This doesn't seem right. Something's off here. You know, things that make you go, all I'm asking you to do, good people, is think. Think about it. That's all I'm saying. I'm not saying that law enforcement is wrong. I don't know. But doesn't seem totally right either. But anyway, keep your eyes open and ears. But I hope we can get this thing under control. But what I'm saying is, I do believe this is political. And we're coming up on 24, the election cycle. And maybe it's just me, but I think people are desperate. And you know who they be. Until next time, this is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker. Subscribe, share, and like to keep me rocking on the mic. Have a good night.